So I'm all for that. But I think we do have a bit of naivete about contemporary commercial hip-hop and the degree to which it is managed and manipulated, not only by the artists who are more interested in making money and making sure they stay in the industry, but by the industry itself. I said this somewhere else recently, so I will repeat it here. Think of all of the things about race and racism and oppression that you do not hear in commercial hip-hop. Now, as I said before, I'm at this point in my life, I wasn't always this way, but a relatively privileged African American, and I've thought on many occasions what it would be like if black folks just, you know, had all gone out with guns and just, you know, shot up some places, because you have that experience every once in a while. Even people who have relative, you know, wealth compared to the rest of the world, you know, you have these moments of, boy, if I just had a gun right now, you know, and one more glass of wine, you know, this would be a bad night. You know, one more comment like, boy, it's just, wow, how did you, you're so articulate. I'm just wondering, did you go to diction school? You know, so, you know, you have these moments where you just, you know, you're like, you're like Pam Grier, you know, out of nowhere. You're like about to go crazy. Now, where are all of the videos and songs about wanting to kill racist people? Where are these rap songs? Don't tell me that none of these brothers sit around saying that off record. And why isn't it on record? Why are there no videos? Why can you have videos of, you know, almost Brazilian level bikini wax close-ups of African-American women's private parts, but nobody, you know, fighting and killing a racist or even taking a gun out for the purposes of armed self-defense or even showing police doing something wrong or housing discrimination? I could list everything. You never see, BET won't even consider playing it. But when it comes to raising the question about using the N-word, where people are basically allowed to speak about themselves in whatever way we want, we get all cultural, you know, Afro, you know, it's just what they do. They just, that's what they say, right? But they talk about structural racism and oppression. You know, you really shouldn't generalize. You know, this is a violent thing. You're really proposing that, you know, that black people hurt them. You know, it's too militant, right? And then all of a sudden everybody wants to shape and frame your speech. I think we have to be very careful about having a fantasy about hip-hop artists being equivalent to a hip-hop community of interested young people. These are two different constituencies. And the artists who are interested in making money, the ones who do it well, some of them are incredibly creative. Don't mishear me. They're not creative. But they know what they can say, what they can't say, what they will say and what they won't say, and they do it to stay visible in the market. And if we keep imagining that that's the same thing as a broke black male, female on some street corner who's trying to listen to it, if we equate those two, we can never make the critique we need to make, and we can never free the people we're trying to free.